just wanted to sit at the edge of human knowledge and just push it ever so slightly forward. But I was very nervous about it.
What if the key to solving climate change was hiding in plain sight in something as ordinary as methane? I'm en route to Oakland, California today on my way towards a quick visit to two Stanford scientists who turned that very idea into reality, splitting methane into hydrogen and graphite to create critical battery materials and to decarbonize heavy industry. So let's go find out how two PhDs went from academic curiosity to startup success. How did the story begin?
Met doing our PhDs at Stanford in material science, studying perovskite solar cells.
Yeah. We just spent a lot of late nights in the lab together.
Yeah, it was really during the pandemic, and we had a lot of time to think. World shut down, emissions only dropped by about 7%. We're like, wow, there's a lot of work to do here.
At the time, both of us had full-time jobs. I was working at VC.
From Germany, right?
Yeah. Kevin was at Swift.
And we just set up a weekly call to just talk about decarbonization. We started riffing.
Cross time zone calls while both juggling day jobs and without a clear idea yet just goes to show how important a fierce curiosity is in these early days to constantly question and learn and iterate even as you build. I asked them what they actually chatted about in these calls and how they discovered Molten's central idea.
You know, we're just going to learn as much as we can about all these areas that have a real need for deep decarbonization: steel, cement, direct air capture, grid scale energy storage. Brainstorming, run through our key assumptions, spend the next week going and reading research papers or trying to talk to people that we knew who were experts and try to validate or disprove all those assumptions, and then rinse and repeat the next week.
The starting point for this is we believe that we can make the lowest costs environmentally friendly graphite for lithium-ion batteries.
We're developing a world first by taking methane, splitting it into graphite and clean hydrogen. We're not only replacing existing industries that are really polluting and dirty, but we're doing that in a way that's more efficient to create this domestically produced critical material at a higher efficiency and lower cost than the way it's done today. Graphite that we need for energy storage and energy security moving forward to empower American industry.
Kevin and Caleb also started out as academics. And I'm always curious to know what that transition towards startup life looks like. I asked how tough it was to leave the lab behind and embrace the high stakes realities of being an early stage founder.
PhDs, especially in materials, are, I would say, incredibly humbling. You fail every day. But I kind of got addicted to that learning cycle. And that's super valuable to take into building a company.
And how did you guys actually build the team?
I mean, Caleb and I talk a lot about iteration cycle and learning cycles. And we built our whole team structure kind of around this culture of just super fast learning, super small, tight engineering team, and just builders.
Yeah, we started out in 2021 working out of a garage at Stanford.
Really, we took all this thermal fluid modeling and we applied it over to methane pyrolysis and some insights on how to overcome this carbon clogging problem that's been plaguing the industry for 100 years. And for the first time ever, our reactor started raining this like shiny carbon material. I thought we made diamond at that time. We didn't make diamond, we made graphite flakes. But we were jumping up and down with joy. That was May 2023. We've come a long way since then. Today, we operate out of a 30,000 square foot facility in Oakland.
We've created an amazing team, entirely technicians and engineers.
Quick to test, quick to learn, and just builders.
We're scaling up 20x, building out our first of a kind demo facility, and reaching a stage where we'll be able to produce 3 tons of graphite and 1 ton of hydrogen every day. You just look at the things that those commodities feed into, things like fertilizer,
thermal energy storage, new synthetic chemical routes,
things like batteries, drones,
and humanoid robots.
Things like decarbonizing steel, actually talk about e-fuels.
All of a sudden you're creating this future where we're doing this in a way that is environmentally friendly and carbon neutral, but also in a way that is unlocking these industries to grow and scale and actually allow humanity to flourish in a way that it hasn't before. That's what gets me out of bed every morning.
Now, if you're watching this, you're probably familiar with the startup journey never being straightforward, but I wanted to know more about being co-founders and how they navigate that journey together without losing their way and without losing each other.
I mean, Molten started as a cement company. We had this idea to do oxy-fuel combustion to make carbon neutral cement. Gosh, we thought a lot about the cost model then. Became concerned that it wasn't really an economically viable business to pursue this cement path. I was telling Caleb, I don't think this is gonna work. I don't think this is gonna scale. So we talked about it for a bit and Caleb was like, okay, let's shut it down tomorrow. I think a lot of companies could get stuck in that spot. It's scary, it's very stressful.
Kevin is a crazy genius in terms of wants to just expand the possibilities and all the ideas. I'm more of a refiner, and so that's how we would work together, is Kevin would just throw out these crazy ideas and then I would go and try to refine and see how far you could get it before it became not feasible. And then we'd just jump into a completely different crazy idea.
Yeah, it worked really well.
So you're doing it, it's real now.
It's kind of exciting now because we've joined that industry and we're actually making a critical material for lithium-ion batteries. I guess what I'm most excited about is I actually think this is gonna work.
And we didn't really think it was gonna come to anything. We just kind of started as, let's just, you know, have fun and do this and see what it leads to. Then it started getting really serious.
Yeah, yeah. What Kevin and Caleb are building at Molten Industries is proof, really, that the answers to climate change and energy security won't come from playing it safe. They'll come from radically reimagining what's possible. You know, I think as the world shifts beneath our feet with rising energy demands and an ever more urgent climate crisis, it feels often like the most daring ideas will be the ones that solve the unique challenges of our time. So here's the question I'm left with for today. What's the bold solution that you see that no one else does yet? And what would it take for you to start building it today? Something to think about. Until next time.